Yo, what is up, guys? We got another video for today, and it's actually a pretty amazing video because I just copped a new pet. Yes, just amazing, guys. New pet in the house, okay? We got a scorpion species. Not any scorpion species, okay? This is actually one of the most venomous scorpion species in the world.
The fuck?
The whole entire world, there's only one. There's only one Earth. And this is one of the most venomous species of scorpion in the only one world.
Boy!
In the only one Earth. Yeah, what the hell am I even saying at this point?
Shut up!
And tell them what genus of scorpion it's in.
It is actually known as Androctonus. I don't know how to say the scientific name. Go, Herping, hit him with the scientific name right now, please.
It's pronounced Androctonus, you fool.
So yeah, you guys know how to say it correctly now, but that word Androctonus actually translates to man killer. Yes, so this scorpion is under the genus man killer in Greek. Without further ado, let me introduce you guys to this species of scorpion right about now, and yeah, let's get into this video. Now, why the hell is my remote here? Yeet that junk the hell away. Now, in this container right here, lies the most venomous scorpion species in the world. And yeah, without further ado, I got my tongs, I got my coffee, we about to be geeked, and we're just gonna open this container. Where the hell is the scorpion? Holy crap, holy crap. Oh, there's the scorpion, of course. Y'all see that right there? Hiding in that leaf. Y'all see that stinger though? Jeez, that chunk fat as hell. That thing long, that thing black, that thing dangerous.
Yeah, boy.
I do not want to mess with that. Oh my gosh. Now, when I was making this girl's setup, I did find out that the scorpion's actually able to climb out of this enclosure by itself. So yeah, if I don't have the lid on, there's a chance that the scorpion might climb out and then just like walk on me and then sting me and then I'll die. And then my parents will be really mad. So then they'll kill me again. So then I'll die twice in one day. So we got tongs and I need to make sure that I keep my eye on the scorpion at all times. Now I do want to get a closer shot of the scorpion for you guys. I'm actually using stuff with my left hand right now because just the way that I'm filming, it's kind of awkward, but look at that. Look at that. Y'all see this scorpion?
Yes.
Do y'all see this scorpion? This thing is beautiful. Freaking, okay. That's a little bit defensive posture, I think. Not 100% sure. Stinger is up and ready to sting. Her, okay, yeah, she's just looking for a place to hide right now. Now, even though the scorpion is highly, highly venomous and is dubbed a man killer, doesn't mean that it's out to get you, okay? So if you see any scorpion species in the wild, make sure to just leave them alone, especially if you don't know what type of species of scorpion it is.
Eventually.
Same with spiders, bro. Like, why you gotta hit spiders in the face and just smash them, bro? Like, come on! It's not nice. That's not nice at all.
Aww.
Now, you could see the scorpion looks hella healthy. I mean, look at that. Look at that scorpion. It's a thick one. That is one thick scorpion. She a thick one. Kim K looking at.
Headshot. 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 Headshot.
Now, I've had this scorpion for about 5 days now. And 3 of those days, I was actually at my dad's. And yeah, I wasn't actually able to supervise this thing at all. So I have not been able to feed it whatsoever since I've had it. I kind of want to feed it, bro. So I think we should try that right about now. So let's get a good food item. I gotta make sure I cap this thing so I don't freaking die, obviously. So we kicking it in the roach bin. We gotta find a little roach to sacrifice. And I'm feeling a little grimy. So I think I'm not gonna use no tongs right now, okay? We just about to be on some grimy stuff. What roach should be sacrificed? I think these are a little bit too big and too small. I want the perfect size roach, guys. The perfect size roach. One that you could just see the annihilation happen. Now, this one's a good candidate because it's freshly molted. So,
excellent!
Yeah. My scorpion should have no problem just demolishing this roach right here. So, I think that's a good sacrifice. And yeah, let's put you somewhere where you'll be nice and safe.
Nice shot!
Drop you right there. This fool better not escape, because then there'll be a roach inside my room, and I don't want that to happen.
Analyzing. Analysis.
Why you look like an American cockroach? Yo, this is mad suspect. This thing mad suspect. Oh, hell no. Yo, you mad suspect, bro. That thing's an imposter. Just a better reason why I should feed that thing off. Boom. Close that thing. Put it back under my... Hey! You mother... You mother... You... Hey, 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 hey. This fool wildin'. Hey, you buggin'. This bug bugging. Did I just smash it?
Goodbye.
Okay. Ah, you mother, come on, stop. Stop it. Stop the cap. Stop the kid. You freaking, you dirty housewife. Holy crap. Stop running. Stop it. Stop it, you freaking wiggler. Okay, this thing's a goddamn wiggler. No, we're just gonna drop this thing in. You know, this everything's not going according to plan. Let me just, come on. That was hella uneventful. Oh my gosh. Okay, come on, dude. We're just gonna use the tongue method, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, it's time for you to meet your lover, slash your destiny, slash the thing that's gonna absorb your insides and use it for nutrition. What the hell? This scorpion just let that roach just crawl on its back, bro. I can't even believe this. A freaking man killer? More like a sensitive lover.
Aww.
What the hell was that? What was that? I bought you because I thought you would be gangster, but you a lamester. Oh my gosh. Okay, come on. We got this. We got this. Come on. You freaking dirty. You dirty roach. Again, bro? Again? I can't even believe my eyes at this point. I can't even believe my eyes. How is this happening? How is this happening? This is just embarrassing. Oh my gosh. Okay.
Few moments later.
Dying. Oh my gosh, the roach is already starting to slow down. Golly, golly. Yo, this roach does not look good, bruh. This roach looks like it is slowly dying. The venom is slowly sinking in to this roach's nervous system. And yeah, the roach does not look like it's gonna survive those three stings. I mean, I can't even survive three stings from this thing. God damn. Holy crap, dude. I freaking love this scorpion. I'm so happy that I copped the scorpion as a pet. The poor roach is still just dying. Now, the scorpion should eat the roach. What am I saying? It probably won't eat the roach, though, knowing my luck. Well, while we wait for this dude to make contact with the roach and actually eat it, let's talk a little bit about the enclosure. Pretty basic, okay? We got some sand as the substrate, a mix of sand and coconut fiber. Now, we got some pottery as some hides. So as I was saying, the pottery, you could see there's plenty of pieces of pottery. I made that on my TikTok, you know what I'm saying? I had this Dollar Tree pottery. I smashed that thing with my head. You know, I hit it with that, yeah, I mean.
Headshot.
And yeah, it smashed up into these little pieces, used that as a hide. And then those other ones are too small for it to be used as a hide. So they're just for decor purposes. You know what I'm saying? We got that leaf. That's not to keep in humidity or anything. I just boiled the leaf. So it's like kind of like moist, you know what I'm saying? But that should dry up and be a perfect little hide for the scorpion as well. And then there's that little piece of cork bark. not cork bark. And then we got that little piece of bark that is also a hide for the scorpion. This rock that the scorpion could possibly use as a hide. I don't know though, it could climb up it, you know what I'm saying, be vibing on the beat. And then this stick for decoration purposes as well as something that it could climb on. Now, we're just gonna move on to the cool fact of this video. So for this cool fact, we're actually gonna have to turn off the lights, okay? And if you're an adamant watcher of invertebrate videos or videos that have to do with creepy crawlies like bugs or anything like that, you probably already know about this fact, but scorpions glow, bro. Y'all see that translucency? And it's not just the light on something, because if I flash it right here, you know what I'm saying, there's not really any glowing. But then if you hit the scorpion, boom, magic. That thing radioactive. That's a radioactive scorpion right there. And you can actually see where the stinger starts.
y'all are about to be a part of one of the first ever audio experiences. So sit back, relax, grab your headphones, and just enjoy this ASMR of some bloopers.
Wait, hold up. Let me hit that. Hold on, let me hit it with my nose, bro.
Boy!
If I actually flash the scorpion's tail with the light, you could actually see where the stinger starts on the scorpion and the tail ends on the scorpion, which is pretty crazy. So that whole black part of the stinger is the actual stinger, and the venom is held at that little round thingy right on the end of that stinger. So if I were to accidentally get stung by this scorpion, that whole black portion of the stinger would literally be going into my skin. The whole black part, bro. That's actually insane to me. Now, let me get a better shot of this radioactive scorpion real quick. Oh my gosh. This thing is stuck on the leaf. Don't sting anything. Now, this scorpion is venomous, not poisonous. And the difference between venom and poison, poison is something that is ingested, and venom is something that is injected. So that's just something that you guys should know. Now let's hit this thing with the light. Ooh, my gosh. Golly. Y'all see that? Do y'all see those colors? This is the most translucent blue I've ever seen on any of my scorpions. I have two other species of scorpions, not counting this one, and they do not look this translucent blue when I flash them. This is so crazy, bro. Oh my gosh, this is my first time seeing a scorpion this blue under UV light. In video, it looks pretty good too, so you guys could probably see this pretty well. This is so crazy, dude. Oh my gosh, golly. I'm actually feeling euphoric right now, dude. Euphoric vibes. Now, where the hell is this goddamn roach, okay? It better not be in my room. I'm probably playing more into the fact that this scorpion might be, like, so venomous and, like, I'm so scared of it. But the truth of the matter is this scorpion is not that defensive at the moment. It is not trying to sting me or anything like that. So I need to chill it on all the extra stuff. And, yeah, I am actually tempted to hold this thing, but I'm just not going to do it, bro. I'm just not going to do it. I just don't want to be dumb, dude. I really don't. Even though I'm really tempted to hold it because it seems so chill, but I'm just not going to do it, guys. Let me tap it. Let me see. See? It's more focused on getting away, which is kind of crazy. This proves that scorpions be trying to save their venom. That's crazy, bro. I actually don't know what I'm saying, so... And just like that, this video is over. So yeah, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to like, comment, subscribe, do all that YouTube stuff, and I'll see you guys on the next one. So late.